Okay, here we are in our new location. Now, you think it's a small lake, but this literally connects to... It's huge. No, if we can get near to the that island, unnamed island, that'd be a good spot. But it's, as you can see, folks, it's gorgeous. And if you look along the shores here, I mean, there's tons of driftwood that is dried and ready to provide lots of heat. Right now, folks, the wind, at least we just came around a bit of a turn. I don't feel any wind. So we're doing good here. You'll see a lot of trees chopped down, basically chopped down, old trees. I mean, they basically are grayed by the sun and the water and the elements. But as I mentioned earlier, just tons of driftwood. There's absolutely no excuse to chop a tree down here. You would never do that. Folks, if you didn't hear what he was saying, basically there's this piece of land from the satellite that looks like a ball sack. I think it looks like gonzo, but I guess the label that we're putting on is the ball sack. If I feel inclined and I'm not lazy, I'll just show a clip of that on the video. But apparently, yeah, it's a better place to camp. There's hiking trails around here, so we want to steer clear from them. So, but it's hard, of course, when you're on ground level to see what that piece of ball sack, piece of land looks like. Okay, so there's times we can see the rock / stump. Right now, obviously I can see what's over here. This place looks like it's been nuked. You got stuff up? Yeah, okay. The helmsman. Straight? Okay. Actually, keep away from to the left. Not sure how much further we're going to get out of this, but it is interesting paddling, I must say. So we'll probably end up turning around shortly, because I can see it getting even, at least up to that point, 50 feet ahead. It looks...
Go straight ahead until it veers to the left, and that's where I'm going to put in.
Okay. Because I don't even hear the ATVs anymore, so... can we get past this?
Whoa.
You almost have to go a little bit to the...
Yeah, I don't even know if I'm going to talk.
Yeah, me... Okay, let me do the spinning. Or just let the current take it. There we go. Okay, we gotta flip it, sir. How you tip your canoe, you get caught up sideways. Okay. Now it's probably harder to see the rocks. So folks, we're not camping here because we're right at the end of the lake, and we have a rush of cold air that's coming in, which will...
You only have to camp in a wind tunnel once before you realize, hey, I'm never going to do that again.
And we've done that. It's 4:30. It is clouding over. We will be getting rain, and apparently it's going to clear up by midnight. I got my... Oh, it's supposed to cool down a lot.
Yeah, it's going to cool down a lot, and we're losing the sun. So.
Yeah. What we did in preparation for the bit of rain is under the canoe there, we got some dry wood. Well, we knew this was coming. It is 6 o'clock, and it's raining. But we got the sill tarp up, and I don't know if you can see it from the camera there, but the fire is hanging in there. So hopefully this actually stops. I mean, the good news is tomorrow and Monday are going to be nice.
The good news is that our gear is in waterproof containers, and that we'll just wait for it to stop raining to set up.
Yep. This is, in the scheme of stuff we've been out, i.e. horizontal rain, this is nothing. And if you're going to camp in Nova Scotia and not come
this
to...
This is a minor nuisance.
Yeah. At least there's no mosquitoes buzzing around our head. All right, so... So it's almost 7 o'clock. It's still raining. And listening to the Blue Jays game. It's not supposed to stop raining till midnight. Anyways, you can't see it, but in the distance I got my sill tarp up. And but haven't set up the hammock yet. Okay, so let's do the creepiest lighting possible. So it's 8:46, and you know how we kind of let's take two. They were calling for the weather to continue raining until midnight. Well, it's 8:46, and the skies are clear. This place is a 10, because there's no highway to be heard. The only thing, the only noise we're hearing right now is the occasional high, the jet passing by at 33,000 feet.
I'll add it.
Bum, 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 bum.
Pounding on the door. That actually bothered me as a kid. I'm thinking, well, is Wilma ever going to come to the door and let Fred in?
Ah, that's what it is. Maybe someday Fred will win the fight. Then the dog will stay open.
So it's 10:44. I have my tarp hammock up. The cot idea fell through. So no cot, just hammock. And underling is doing something we've done dozens of times in the dark, late at night. Setting up hammocks. So he's just doing his fantasy here. Two O-rings. So we came down to get the fire going, and lo and behold, it's still smoking. Now, let me add this. Never leave a fire going when you go to bed. But when we went to bed, it was downpouring. But we have a coal to work with, and that's all you need. But if it wasn't raining, we would have put this out thoroughly. So I'm going to stop filming and work with this. Thank you.
High humidity, cold temperatures.
Well, it was raining last night. And cold. The water filter, I hope you kept it somewhat warm. Thing with water filters is that you don't want to let them freeze, because when they freeze, they're probably
nothing froze.
No, I'm just saying they'll probably damage it. But it wasn't freezing temperatures, although it was definitely cold. Okay. Anyways. This is my coffee. Thanks, Ann, for the loan of the thermos, Ann. Thank you. So, got my ground coffee, my Tim's ground coffee in there. And then there's a nice little spill-proof lid that goes with this. Excellent. And my coffee filter fits perfectly and snugly on that, because there's lips inside of there. Anyways.
Is that why it's doing? Are you forcing us?
Nice.
Okay, I just wanted to get this on video. You can see this here. Probably wondering what this could be. Well, apparently it's an old road. Old road, meaning probably 100, 150, 200 years old, possibly. And you can see the remnants of the road as it goes up and travels along the shore. Now, I need to point out something is that when this road was being used, probably more than likely by horses and carriage or whatever, there was no water here because this is a man-made lake. And of course, you see all the tree stumps. So, you know, they were traveling through a forest. And because it's been such a long time, is that eventually when this road, if I follow this road up to the end of the lake there, it's going to hit a wall of trees because it's grown over. But it's just cool that you can still see some of it still here. And here's more, another shot of the old road structure. Don't see any nails. So I don't think this was nailed down. I think it was just these old logs were just laid here on top of a larger log. The first load that we got was ridiculous, and I didn't have the camera with me. I had it on shore, but you've seen from the clip. I mean, we were grabbing, you know, stuff like that. It was high up on the boat, which of course messes with the center of gravity and makes the boat so much easier to tip. And I don't want to go dunked in at 2 degrees Celsius into this lake. Wouldn't be a good time. Muddy, whatever, anything better than rocks. Scratch up at the bottom of the canoe. And more scratches, more drag. Awesome. Okay, for late lunch today, I am going to have extra creamy cheddar compliments Kraft dinner, not just by itself, but I'm going to add some grated Parmesan cheese and compliments as well. And since I love cheese, a couple of slices of these little guys here. And we're not done yet. No sorry, Bob. The next part of this gourmet Kraft dinner is going to be, whoa, let me dig in my tickle trunk, some flame roasted beef sirloin strips. Yes, it will be good. It will be good. Look at that. If that's not perfection, camping perfection. Let's try a bite. Oh God. Oh boy. Oh God. Oh, that's good. I gotta shut the camera off. Okay, the wind's coming from our right, so we're gonna take the canoe and pull it up here as a windbreak, and then sit right on the ground. and see how that works. How far up? Probably further up. You'll need one on this end, but that could work. That could work very well. 5:30, sun's going down. We rearranged the rocks here, and of course with the canoe. It's our second day, so we're gonna be getting up early tomorrow at 7, packing up, and then heading out to get picked. No, I did that because that is not comfortable at all.
This?
Yeah.
Well, wonderful wood.
I'm almost tempted to go in the woods back there and get that plank. Yes, we're getting up at 7 and getting picked up for 10.
Next time, no firing. Just a bed of rocks and you throw shit on.
Calm down, sir. Okay, folks. Well, that's it. Mid-fall 2015 canoe outing. Until next time, happy trails, everybody. I don't know the words of that song. Happy trails.
Happy trails to you. Until we meet again, happy trails.